tijd roepen we hier altijd gewoon Nederlandse poëzie. Maar ja, als jij uit Afghanistan komt en een mooi gedicht hebt in het Dari, wat we nou ook in vertaling moest gelezen, dan zeg ik, ja zeker! En hier is voor jullie eerst in het Dari, dus de taal van Afghanistan is dus direct Dari. Dat is ongeveer hetzelfde als Farsi, alleen een andere naam, hè? Dat is een stuk duidelijker. Het gaat voor jullie gelezen worden en daarna de vertaling in het Engels. Maar eerst gaan we luisteren naar Somaya Ramish!
شعرهایت را با بارود پر کن شعرهایت را با بارود پر کن باید مسلح باشی جغرافیای جنگ است اینجا هیچ نشانی رنگی نشانه دشمن ندارد شعرهایت را با بارود پر کن هر لحظه توپی، تفنگی، انفجاری، مرگی هیچ قانونی ندارد مرگ هیچ قانونی ندارد جنگ هزار بار هم ورقهای سفید را بیرق کنی کلماتت را قورت دهی و هیچ نگویی باز هم شعرهایت را با بارود پر کن تنت را، اندیشت را، مدرسه های جنگ از درونت به پا می خیزن. شاید نفر بعد خودت باشی. Thank you.
Nu komt hij. Hey, in het Engels nog.
Ja.
Weten jullie. Oké, ik dacht dat ik de volgeloving aankondig. Weten jullie dat de Taliban verboden hebben dat dit soort avonden nu in Kabul gehouden worden?
Lees de vertaling.
Load poems like guns. Load poems like guns. War's geography calls you to arms. The enemy has no signs, counter signs, colors, signals, symbols. Load poems like guns. Each moment is loaded with bombs, bullets, blasts, death sounds. Death and war don't follow rules. You can make your pages into white flags 1,000 times. But swallow your words, say no more. Load your poems, your body, your thoughts, like guns. The schoolhouses of war rise up within you. Maybe you are next.
Mensenrechtenactivist, dichter en schrijfster uit Afghanistan. Het land waar vorig jaar door het vertrek van de buitenlandse strijdkrachten de Taliban wederom de macht greep. Daardoor kunnen vrouwen niet meer naar school of werk en is poëzie een verboden activiteit. Dat is ook de reden dat zij naar haar land niet meer in kan, nadat de Taliban Afghanistan overnam. Inmiddels heeft Somaya het Poetry House opgericht. Van daaruit roept ze dichters over de hele wereld op poëzie te schrijven voor Afghanistan. En er zijn hier dichters, dus dichters, scherp de pen. We kwamen haar tegen in het verhalenhuis op Katendrecht en gaven haar een plek in ons programma. Ze schrijft en leest ook zo in het Dari en de vertaling wordt voorgelezen door Jannie Dieriks. Ga nu uw aandacht voor Somaya Ramish.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
Hello everyone. I'm really happy that give me this opportunity. Thank you. And thank you for my best friend Yanni that she is since I'm living in Rotterdam just helping me and give my hand that I could stand again and be active. Thank you so much. Before I read my poetry a little bit, I want to explain about the things that we are doing. As you know, after Afghanistan fall in the hand of Taliban, people of Afghanistan lost everything in Afghanistan. And recently, Taliban banned writing poetry. And also, all kind of art in Afghanistan is banned, music, theater, painting, everything. Now, we published a call and published Bamdad, House of Poetry in Exile. And my request from all poets from all around the world is please stand with us against the censor, against the ban of poetry, and just sing a poetry for us to support poets and art in Afghanistan. Thank you so much. And I want to...
Poesie is oorlog.
Nou, de bundel van de vorige directeur van Poetry International, die heet ook zo.
Poetry
in oorlog, ja. Nou, dus poëzie in oorlog is alles toe te gaan.
Poetry is our power and I believe you touch my words in Persian or Dari because art is our common language.
شعرهایت را با بارود پر کن. شعرهایت را با بارود پر کن. باید مسلح باشی. جغرافیای جنگ است اینجا. هیچ نشانی، رنگی، نشانه ای دشمن ندارد. شعرهایت را با بارود پر کن. هر لحظه توپی، تفنگی، انفجاری، مرگی. هیچ قانونی ندارد مرگ. هیچ قانونی ندارد جنگ. هزار بار هم که ورقهای سفیدت را بیرق کنی، شعرهایت را قورت دهی و هیچ نگویی، باز هم شعرهایت را، تنت را، اندیشت را با بارود پر کن. شاید نفر بعد خودت باشی.
I was not yet born.
Oh, sorry.
I thought so. Yeah. I started to read.
Because my phone just gone.
Oh, okay. It's just one poem then. Load poems like guns. Wars, geography calls you to arms. The enemy has no signs, countersigns, colors, signals. Symbols. Load poems like guns. Each moment is loaded with bombs, bullets, blasts, death sounds, death and war. Don't follow rules. You can make your pages into white flags 1,000 times, but swallow your words, say no more. Load your poems, your body, your thoughts, like guns. The schoolhouses of war rise up within you. Maybe you are next.
به دنیا نبودم. مادر وطن را درون بغچش پیشید و رفت از خودش تا لاف من با جنگ گره نخورد. اما خوراک اصلی ما جنگ با اخبار هر ساعت شب بود. سلول های ما قرابت خود را با رنج، درد، زخم می دانستند. ما هیچ جایی نرفته بودیم. در 9 سالگی فهمیدم جغرافیا مزخرف است. بقچه مادر را در 14 سالگی باز کردم. عطرش مرا پیچی. با 7 پشت پدرم برگشتم. وطن دیگر اخبار ساعت جنگ نیست. جغرافیای جنون است در رگهای من. لبه تیغی با 2 پهلو. مرگ.
I was not yet born when mother wrapped our country into her bundle and abandoned her own self, so that my navel would not be tied to the rope of war. But our mighty meals became the hour night. Then our nightly meals became the hourly meals of war. Ourselves recognized their own exile in our suffering, pain, and wounds. We had never traveled before, but at age 9 I learned the absurdity of geography. At 14, I untied my mother's bundle. Its aroma enfolded me, returned me to my forefathers. Now, my country is not just the news of war, it's a madness of geography that courses through my veins. It's a two-edged blade, death and death.
I bring the colors. If someone wants to send us poetry, the email is here. And maybe I put it here if you want. Just thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Somaya.
Yes, yes.
Alright. So, yeah, as jij iets spreekt. So you can. So everybody can hear everybody, right?
Yeah.
You can hear her.
Yeah.
Is the volume okay when it comes to, is it too loud or too soft or something like that? Okay. So.
So,
yeah, cool?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
ik moet nog even checken hoe dit ingezet is. Can you just keep speaking, please?
Yes. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Again?
Goed zo.
Yeah,
yeah,
okay.
Exactly.
This, that's 4. En jij bent dan
ja,
als jij wil blijven.
Ik ben
nummer 3. En jij bent nummer 2. En ik ben nou 1. Oké. In English, Thea, just keep the microphone quite close to your face, and then, so, yeah, I can keep it tegenaan. Okay.
Gaan we dit een beetje zo bij
dat. And in 3, 2, 1. Dames en heren en alles daar tussenin, ladies and gentlemen and everything in between, welcome to a very special edition of The Next Step. We are at a very big art exposition organized by Werklicht. There's going to be lots of sounds everywhere. There's lots of people in the room, but we're going to try to make a podcast. So welcome, everybody. We have on my right Thea, one of the organizers of this exhibition.
Hello.
Then across the table we have, can you please introduce yourself?
I'm Jannie Dierks. I live in Rotterdam, and I'm here with Maya Ramish. She became my friend last year, and she's one of the poets that's performing here today.
All right. Hi, Somaya.
Hello.
Hello. Yeah. Nice to meet all of you. I've never met you guys, so the names are probably gonna. Well, okay. My podcast is about a question, and that is, what is the next step for humans and society in the 21st century? And one of the things that I focus on very much is art. I love interviewing artists, poets, musicians, like therapists, healers, and stuff like that. And Somaya, right? You, I saw you just perform a little bit of poetry, not in the Dutch language. Can you explain what your poetry is about?
Yes, my poetry was about the things that I experienced in the war geography. I come from Afghanistan, and a big part of my poetry written in Afghanistan. by that feeling and by the experience I had in award geography, because of that, the things that today you heard about that I really heard about. It was about the situation in Afghanistan, about the suffering, about the pain, about the inequality and everything that as a human and as a woman I experienced in my society.
Okay, one of the lines you said is load poetry like a loaded gun. No, sorry, I'm
load poems like guns.
Load poems like guns. So you want to kill people with poetry, or what do you mean?
I'm a poet, and I believe that words has power, and they can be practical, effective on society. Because of that, I write this poetry and say, yeah, you should be ready for everything. And as a, you know, sometimes we have responsibility about everything that happens all around the world. We couldn't see everything and be silent about everything. And in other hands, we couldn't close our eyes as a human, as an artist, and as a poet, to reality of the world, that all crazy things that continue. And because of that, I write these poems, be a lot of poems like guns. And again, I want to say, I fit to the world, and I believe we can bring a little bit change to the society by the art.
Well, it's, I believe in that very strongly as well. Thank you. My God. Thea, English. Let's try. How is it, because this exposition, it's quite big, it's 100 artists.
300.
Around one. 300 artists? My goodness. 325, Theo, what are you doing?
Around 400.
So around 400 different artists, all from also Ukraine as a beneficiary, because the art pieces are being auctioned off for. So how is it organizing? How is it to organize such a big exposition with so many different artists? Because artists are, well, your partner is a very beautiful example of this, but they can be chaotic, and they have their own will and opinions and stuff like that. But
well, it's great. It is a lot of work, but it is very great.
Okay. And what are like things that you that were very nice in the organization, that you are very, that went very easy, and what are things that were quite hard in this process?
It is very intensive. We are the organizing 4 months here in this. Last week we are working on the morning until night.
All right.
And I my own own job, I have to, just working at my job, and then go to expo, and I'm working until night, meeting, work, sleeping.
So very much from the heart, and very...
Next week's
All right. I have a question for you, because you are a very good friend. Sorry, what's your name again? Someya.
Romish, it's more easy.
And what was your name again?
Yanni Dierks.
Yanni. What kind of role did you step in when it comes to supporting this person in front of me? Because she's from Afghanistan, and you translate her poems as well.
And also her articles, I translated it. I use Google Translate. I like to write myself, so I think I'm able to get the gist of it, and that's also a way to have a good friendship. The first day I met Someya, she was reading poetry in the garden of Rotterdam, next to the old prison, the new statue with the Via Freedom. That was where we met, and that was special from the first moment. So that the poetry and the way she she read low poems like us as well there. And it really, I really got really angry. I thought, yeah, what is happening?
With a translation or in
Dari? In Dari.
In Dari,
in Dari and with the translation. But also the Dari, I think you hear it. It's like it's like music. Something, it hits you. Something is going on with these words. So yeah, that's the power of poetry, I guess. So it's also very nice that we have these afternoons now.
Alright.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And I introduced her to Verhalenhuis Belvedere, and I didn't know.
Which is in Rotterdam.
Which is
at Kaatsheuvel
right
now.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I got to know the people as well, and they're very welcoming. And I've been living in abroad myself, and it's always very nice when the community of in this case the poets that where you come to live. She fled from Afghanistan through Moscow, Turkey to the Netherlands. And it's very nice that people are welcoming. And I think the Rotterdam Poet Society is really very nice for her. And for me as well, it becomes more easy to help her to translate stuff. I was very proud in January, she published an article in NRC Handelsblad, which is an important newspaper in the Netherlands.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and then the Eén Vandaag came to film her, which is very nice. She wants to become a voice also. This poem, she low poems like guns, she wrote already years ago. But now that the Taliban just actually banned poetry, that you cannot make it, well, they cannot prohibit you to write poetry, but they can prohibit you to publish it, to read it together, to have an evening together. It's all prohibited. And this poem is now the an outcry that it's more important even, and she's trying to get poets around the world also to use this poem and to write poetry themselves about Afghanistan and about a country where you're supposed not to even read or enjoy or write or publish poetry, which is crazy.
All right.
Yeah.
And to close off the English section of this podcast, do you find yourself in this experience? Can you describe the Rotterdam experience for you? Because how long was it ago that you came here?
Mm-hmm. It's 1.5 years that we just come in Netherlands after the fall of Afghanistan, but since almost 1 year ago, I'm living in Rotterdam, and I found everything fantastic because during this 1 year, I introduced it and I, you know, connected in different cultural literature and social organization, and also with artists, writers, and someone who are doing, you know, in this area, they have activity. And I think I'm so happy that I faced with really kind people that really helped me to find myself again. It's fantastic for me, the experience that I have from human connection in Rotterdam. It's fantastic, yeah, you can just see it now with the things that the contribution, the kindnesses that Yeni doing for me, and you know, it's very special. It's the things that world need to it. You know, it's my feeling. It's the experience that I have. You know, everything that becomes by machine, the decision taken by machine, by technology, by, you know, machine just sitting in a state of human and the decision, and these things make everything very difficult. We need to more, you know, humanity in the society. You know, if we look to the systems, to the machine, to the rules that they are making for us, the life is very, you know, difficult. And this is the humans that comes
and make the life easy for the others. It's the things that I experience since I'm living in Rotterdam. Because if these very nice people doesn't help me and my family, I really don't know what's happened in my life. Because you know, we were lost everything in Afghanistan and we just came here, and I feel how I can, you know, continue the life without the all things that I need in my life, and now I lost them. I come in a new country, I don't know the language, I don't know the people, I don't know the rules, I don't know anything, and you know, and I don't have anything in my hands, you know. And without this friendship, without this humanity, I couldn't speak today with you. And I think it's, I believe it's the things that world in future needed to it. And I think it's one of their responsibility that art and artists have. Yeah.
Wow, thank you very much for that expression. You told about a project that you guys have. Where can people find this project? Do you have like something to plug, an Instagram or whatever? Or
it's a very new movement. Just from 3 weeks ago, I'm starting this project with the help of some people. We don't have any website, but everything just published in my Facebook, Somaya Ramish, and I'm trying to make a website for that. And just we are by email and Facebook, just we spread this call. And I want to say, we were very successful because we get lots of response from different country. For example, Pen International in the French published our call. Also, Pen Club in Spain, in American Latin, also they are published our call. And we receive lots of poetry from different country. And it's a big achievement, but even it's not enough. We need more sympathy. We need more support.
But what is a physical address that people can send it to? Do you have that by hand? Yanni?
Yeah, the Gmail account.
What's the Gmail account?
Afghanistan.poetry@gmail.com.
Right.
Yeah. And there will be a website, but we are just, you know.
Hey, that's what these kind of platforms are for.
Yeah, yeah.
Yanni and what was your name?
Somaya.
So, thank you very much for coming on the podcast.
Thank you.
Let's see if this art can translate and transmute and bring people closer to each other.
Thanks for doing a great job. And
yeah, no worries. Thank you for coming on. Okay.
Thanks a lot.
That's all.
Engelse stukje, Nederlandse stukje.
Wow. What a speech, Somaya.
Great.
Yeah, very nice.
Yeah.